हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी दैट नॉइज चैप्टर रिलेटेड टू और थ्री पॉइंट्स रिमेनिंग रिलेटेड टू दैट नॉइज चैप्टर विच इज बिलोंगिंग टू एनालॉग कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट। दैट सब्जेक्ट गिव्स अस रिलेटेड टू नॉइज एंड एवरीथिंग पैरामीटर्स रिलेटेड टू नॉइज विच वी आर गोइंग टू कंसिडर व्हाइल डिजाइनिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ ए स्ट्रक्चर रिलेटेड टू नॉइज और ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ एनी काइंड ऑफ ए सिग्नल। Along with that signal to noise ratio, that is a S by N ratio, we are going to study today. Here I have mentioned that is a signal to noise ratio. But then what is the definition related to signal to noise ratio came into picture, I am going to tell you. That is in communication system, the compression of a signal power with the noise power at the same point is important to ensure that the noise point, that is a point to not exactly exclusively large. It is defined as it is the ratio of signal power to the noise power at the same point. And that is a signal to noise ratio is mentioned at a PS means what signal power and PN means what noise power. Where here I have used that is a where the terminology is used for the signal to noise ratio, that is a PS is equal to signal power and PN is equal to noise power. Then the signal to noise ratio is normally expressed in dB and typically value of signal to noise ratio ranges from 10 dB to 90 dB higher. The value of signal to noise ratio better the system performance in the presence of the noise. That means whenever the system gives us a signal to noise ratio, that is a signal power to the noise power, that is a ratio with a higher quantity, then the system we are going to considering that is it is a well known system and it is a very good or essential system for the transmission purpose. That is a signal to noise ratio is expressed in terms of dB by using the formula. Here I have mentioned that is a signal to noise ratio in dB is equal to, while we are dealing with in terms of power, then we are going to convert that is in dB by using the formula 10 log to the base 10. So that purpose here signal to noise ratio in dB is equal to 10 log to the base 10 signal power divided by noise power. This is the formula related to signal to noise ratio, which is expressed in dB. Then we are going to study that is a power can be expressed in terms of signal and noise voltage as follows. That is a we know very well what is the relation in between power, voltage and resistance. That is formula is nothing but P is equal to V square by R. For that purpose, by using this formula, we have converted that is a signal power as well as noise power. That is a signal power is equal to voltage square, signal voltage square divided by resistance, and noise power is equal to noise voltage square divided by resistance, where Vs is the nothing but signal voltage, Vn is nothing but noise voltage. That is a S by N ratio. We know very well. Here I have mentioned that is a signal to noise ratio. That is a formula related to signal to noise ratio as a PS divided by PN. Here I have taken that what is the value of PS and what is the value of PN. For that purpose I have replaced that signal to noise ratio. PS is replaced by VS square by divided by R and PN is replaced by VN square divided by R. R are both the common factors. For that purpose these common factors both get cancelled with each other and VS divided by VN bracket square. For that purpose signal to noise ratio is equal to source voltage divided by noise voltage bracket square. This is the signal to noise ratio which is given in dB. For that purpose for the conversion of this signal to noise ratio in dB we are going to use here is the formula. That is a signal to noise ratio in dB is equal to 10 log to the base 10, that is a VS divided by VN bracket square is equal to, here the 20 is present in terms of square. For that purpose, for simplification of this terminology, that square terminology is multiplied by that 10. For that purpose, that 10 is converted as a 20. That means 10 multiplied by 2 is equal to 20. For that purpose, here the simplification of this equation, here I have mentioned that is a 20 log to the base 10. That is a Vs divided by Vn. This is a formula related to signal to noise ratio in terms of dB. Then the signal to noise ratio is a fundamental characteristic of communication system. It is often difficult to measure in practice. Instead of measuring that signal to noise ratio, another ratio is called as a signal to noise, signal plus noise divided by noise is a measure. For example, by taking one example, I am going to show you how this signal to noise ratio is converted in terms of dB. It is here, just see a statement for that mathematical equation. That is a receiver produces a noise power of 100 microwatt when no signal is present at its input. The receiver output power is equal to 3 watt with the signal applied at its input, and calculate the signal to noise ratio divided by 9 ratio as a power ratio and in a dB. That how we are going to calculate that signal to noise ratio, that is a power ratio is S plus N divided by N. For that purpose, noise is a 10%, that is a 0.1. For that purpose, here 3 plus 0.1 divided by 0.1. Then what is the value came into picture? That is 31. Then how we are going to converting that terminology in terms of dB? By multiplying that factor by using 10 log to the base 10, whichever the parameter came here, by taking just simply that parameters 10 log to the base 10, we are getting original value. That is a 10 log to the base 10, 31 is equal to 14.91 dB. This is the final value related to that dB terminology. This is all related to signal to noise ratio parameter. Along with this, noise chapter also involves one another terminology related to noise, is a noise factor. So that we are going to study now that noise factor. What that noise factor tells us, that noise factor F of an amplifier or any network is a defined in terms of signal to noise ratio at that input and output of the system. It is a defined as F is equal to signal to noise ratio at the input divided by signal to noise ratio at the output. That means input ratio divided by output ratio is equal to noise factor. That is, we know very well what is the signal to noise ratio. That means signal input power divided by noise power. For that purpose, here I have mentioned that is a PSI divided by PNI. Then here signal to noise ratio at the output power, what is that value? PSO divided by PNO. But PNO present at the denominator's denominator. For that purpose, reversely, it come under numerator. For that purpose, I have taken here as a PNO divided by PSO. That means signal noise output power divided by signal output power. Where PSI and PNI are the signal and noise power at the input side, and PSO and PNO are the signal and noise power at the output side. The temperature to calculate the noise power is assumed to be a room temperature. What is that room temperature? That room temperature is considered as nothing but it is a 27 degree centigrade. For that purpose, we are going to convert that centigrade temperature into Kelvin by adding 273. Then signal to noise ratio at the input is always greater than that of the output. This is due to the noise added by the amplifier. Therefore, the noise factor is a measured amount of the noise added. It will be always be greater than 1. The ideal value of that noise factor is a unity. The noise factor F is sometimes frequency dependent. Then the value determined at a one frequency is known as the spot noise factor, and that frequency must be stated along with the spot noise factor, and that is the frequency related to this, that is a nothing but noise factor. Okay, all these things related to that noise factor and signal to noise ratio you know very well. Along with this, two more terminologies are remaining related to noise chapter. We are going to study that very well as soon in our next lecture. Okay, thank you.